Hi everybody and welcome back to K-Tapes. Today I'm gonna show you a little walk around of Seoul Video, which is a video store in Seoul, obviously. It's a place I used to go like all the time back in the days, but now it's just that they're phasing out pretty much like all of their videotapes to put clothing instead. So they're selling, like, as you can see, caps, coats. But they received this massive pile of tapes thanks to a friend of mine who actually owns a store in Seoul that is a Korea Disco. He told me about the new arrival of tapes. But as you can see, it's in horrible shape. And I'm just picking up one tape right there. And actually, they're pretty much all like that. So I'm going to show you in a moment, as you can see. It's been hit like really hard by some mold and probably humidity. The person I know, like I said previously, when he went there, he noticed that some of the tapes were actually still wet. So that is usually a very, very bad sign, especially for videotapes. So on the spines that you see here, the great thing though is you can notice there are many late releases, such as here you have Transformers, you have the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the second one from 2006, I think, or 7. So there are like some late releases in there, but they're all as bad as one another, so it's really not worth picking up. I did take actually 3 tapes, and one is going to the trash. I couldn't save it. The other two, I was actually able to save them. So I'm really proud of myself, but it took me like an hour per tape to clean. But they play okay. And they were like some of the least worst tapes of the bunch. So that's why I picked them up. And I was like, well, I'll take a gamble on those and see if I can clean them up. Because also with the price that you pay those tapes when you go there, they're cheap. But thinking that you will go back home with a tape that doesn't even play, it's pretty much just throwing money in the garbage, let's face it. So as you know, I sold all my videotapes about 3 weeks ago. So I'm not planning on collecting tapes again, or for that matter, getting like a whole new inventory. Far from it. That's the last thing I want to do. Oops, right there I dropped the tape. So the last thing I want to do, although I'm still gonna take some special requests, like I said. So I pretty much just went there out of curiosity, and because that same day I was gonna go somewhere else and I had to wait for a friend. So in the meantime, I'm like, well, out of curiosity, I'm just gonna go and browse through those piles of tapes, because I mean, let's face it, I kind of still like to do that, because who knows, maybe I will find something really rare that maybe I cannot pass, and I'll be like, well, I'll pick it up because maybe someone will want it. But but compared with before, I'm not gonna go and buy things thinking I can sell them maybe later. No, I'm done doing that. So here, this is another example of like terrible shape tape. Here, well, he has like the entire collection of Twin Peaks. That's pretty surprising. But I'm ready to bet that they're all terribly moldy. Over there, you have like a couple of late releases down there. Some interesting titles, maybe. I did pull out one or two, but turned out that they were moldy. So I put them back there. If we check up there, same thing, like a bit like some late 90s tapes, nothing good. And if those are moldy, they're probably even worse than the late releases. So they're really not worth picking up. Even if you see something there, chances are the tape is just as the ones I showed you just a few moments ago. Got a couple Korean tapes in there. There's actually one I thought it was something interesting, so I pulled it like really fast. As you can see, I was like, oh my god, is this the tape I was looking for? But no, it's just something from like 2005. So nothing really important. I put it back there. So yeah, I was just double checking the date. But no, it's not the tape I was looking for. There's a couple of erotica. Nothing too good. At the top here, this is perhaps the most interesting part of like the tapes he had. So you can see there's an Indiana Jones there. You have a Hancock, you have the Mummy 3. But I did check all of those and they, no, I didn't take any of these because they were just terrible. In the entrance, he got like a bunch of animations. I'm just slowly panning just to show you what he has. But once again, it's all stuff from the late 90s or very, very early 2000s. So there's nothing good, but there was this one tape here. You know, I never learn from my mistakes, but I'm like, well, maybe I can save it. You know, I have this always this feeling. But yeah, as you can see, look at the conditions. All the tapes are like that, by the way, like regardless. So anyway, I picked this one up and I will try to clean it up. So anyway, guys, thank you for listening and see you again next time.